हेलो। हेलो आयुष। हेलो।
यस सर, हेलो।
गुड गुड गुड, वेरी गुड। गुड इवनिंग।
या नाउ इट्स वर्किंग। या गुड
नाउ इट इज
इवनिंग सर।
वर्किंग। गुड इवनिंग। एक्चुअली आई वाज इन अनदर जूम मीटिंग विथ फॉर
ओके ओके सर, नो इश्यू।
आईटी कैंडिडेट, सो
ओके ओके सर।
दैट इज व्हाई यू कुड नॉट हैव गॉट मी। वेरी गुड। आयुष, आयुष
यस सर।
रस्तोगी, यू आर फ्रॉम विच प्लेस?
सर करेंटली आई एम इन दिल्ली, बट आई बेसिकली बिलोंग टू वाराणसी।
Oh good, you are a UP man.
Yeah, sir, from Uttar Pradesh.
Ayush, UP man. Good, good, good. Ayush Rastogi. That means you are Hindu or Muslim? Because
no, sir, I am Hindu.
आपका yeah. face appearance देखने से थोड़ा Muslim का मापी लगता
है. It's beard. I am Hindu. Otherwise, my name will not be Ayush.
Yeah, Ayush will not be there. Ayush means life.
Achha, Ayush or
you're yeah. You'll be having beard when you go for the interview.
Yeah, sir. I just trim beard to one. Means I only set the beard. Means not clean shave, because it's look very weird on me if I do clean shave.
Achha, 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 achha. You don't like you when you come. You look small. You look very
yes,
young. You look very young.
Yes, sir. I am look like a child without a beard.
Without a beard.
Even I have not seen myself. Yeah.
That's it.
Even I.
But yeah. Now I could get it. Good. I understand that. Even sometimes I feel so. That's right.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, 9-1. Yeah. Good. Now, can you please, did you go through the video I have given for tips for ensuring success?
No, sir, I have not gone through the video. You have shared me the general HR questions and the commerce technical questions.
Yeah, yeah.
Achha, that is one. Yeah, yeah. Tips for ensuring, sir. I have already watched your many videos.
Many
but
videos.
I have not
many
seen videos. This video.
Achha, achha.
Yeah. I have given interview to you. Yeah, sir. I have given interview to you on a call for FCI AGM, sir. Unfortunately, I couldn't clear that. I just means failed by 6 marks. Six marks.
Oh.
Yeah,
interview mein kitna mark mila aapko?
So, interview mein I get a very good marks. That is 17 out of 20.
Oh, great.
But in mains, unfortunately,
I have done
many mistakes. Yeah, I have done many mistakes.
It's okay.
That cost me.
Now you are in Delhi.
Yeah, sir.
Good.
Actually, yeah. NABARD result are yet to become. Means interview, it's not means finalized yet. It is not declared yet.
Achha, achha.
But I'm sure but I will
you're,
meet.
You are sure you will get selected, so you
yeah.
are preparing for.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That is very good. How many posts are there in this NABARD?
In this, there are different discipline posts are in different disciplines. In finance, in which I have applied, there is 21 seats.
Mm-hmm. You have applied for finance.
Yes, I have applied for finance. I am basically a chartered accountant.
Achha.
So I have applied for this
finance
specialization field.
Group finance grade A officer, grade B officer. What is that?
Yes, sir. Grade A officer.
Grade A.
It's officer. Only RBI that recruits for grade B.
Achha.
Other than RBI, other regulatory bodies like NABARD and this SAB, they recruit for grade A. But NABARD also recruit for grade B. But that they are asking for the experience.
Achha, achha. Good.
Many of us
very good.
Not have.
You are a chartered accountant. When did you complete your chartered accountancy?
I have qualified chartered accountancy in January 2019.
Mm-hmm. After that, what you have been doing?
After that, I have joined a CA firm, chartered accountancy firm, in which I have worked for around 2 years, and I have worked in different domains. I have done a statutory audit there of means listed companies and non-listed companies as well, and I have done internal audit as well, and other works like GST audit, return filing. I have also done that.
Yeah,
it's an overall means broader view.
Yeah, yeah. Now, what is the trend of the collection of the direct taxes in our country?
So, direct tax collection are definitely increasing day by day. As most of the people are now filing return of income, and now they are aware that it's necessary to file income if your gross total income exceeds 2.5 lakhs. So this tendency is changing nowadays, and people are started filing ITR and try to disclose the proper income, the correct income in ITR, in order to avoid litigations and all. I think means the direct tax collection.
You think that is the reason for increase in the taxes, correct, Rob?
Yes, are the reasons.
That is your view, correct? Good.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me something about your experience in GST and in GST?
GST was first implemented in 1st of July 2017, and from there we have seen the massive tax collection through indirect taxes, and around more than 1 lakh crore every month and the government are getting from this GST. And GST also facilitates SSEs in means they provide basically ease of doing business. They can easily file RTR, return GST returns, and it also simplifies. Earlier SSE used to file separate returns under many indirect taxes. Like sales tax, there is different return before VAT, there is different. But through the implementation of GST, it becomes very easy for the SSE to track their records and the file returns. This way, it will benefit both to the government as well. They get higher revenues, and to the SSE as well. They get the ease, and to the professionals like us as well.
Good. So are chartered accountants have to pay professional tax, that separate tax is being collected? Like in courier service and all, they collect some taxes. Service charges.
No, sir. There is not as such service charges. We also have to pay GST on our professional services. If total gross receipt from the professional services exceeds 40 lakh rupees, and
how many lakhs?
The 40 lakhs.
40 lakhs.
40.
Yeah, only very few. Very few chartered.
Then we have to charge. Then every person even have to charge GST if their turnover or gross receipt exceed 40 lakh. And this is all about indirect tax. And we also have to pay income tax on our income if our income exceeds rupees 2,50,000 for individuals, and for company there is a flat rate of 30% for all SSE, irrespective of professional services or others. There is one provision that is 44ADA, where professionals can get they have to declare their income as per presumptive basis taxation. It's like a composition scheme where we have to disclose 50% of our revenue as income, and for this the government will they will not ask for any reports or for audit. You can skip that compliances by declaring 50% as your income of gross receipts.
Very good. Now,
so these two taxes are.
What made you have an interest in joining NABARD?
NABARD. Sir, I've always wanted to contribute towards the society. But it's our profession is such like that we cannot directly contribute towards the society, because we work for the wealthy profession. We work for the individuals or organization who are earning money, huge money or taxable amount. We work for them. But by joining NABARD, I will directly work towards the rural development and provide the support to the farmers as well by without skipping my core area of profession. And it is the only the NABARD that provides me this opportunity. Means they only recruit for the grade A position finance domain. Although by chartered accountancy, we do contribute in the GDP, but not in a direct way. We indirectly contributing towards the GDP, but through NABARD, I can directly contribute towards the rural and agriculture development. So yeah. That's why.
So you're
I can correlate my NABARD. Objective with the. Yeah, I can correlate my objective with the NABARD objective. So I believe this is.
Yeah. Now coming to income tax, can you tell me something about the present situation, present talking that is going on about income tax? I am having my Economic Times before me. Here, did you go through some of the reports recently?
Yes, sir. Currently, government is looking for introducing a direct taxation code, basically to override the other acts to simplify the direct taxation law, because direct taxation is the most complicated law in our country. So government wants to simplify it. And even they have made a committee 2 years ago. They have also made a committee in which Kirish Ahuja was a member. They he is a chartered accountant and he is also our teacher. So government is working on this to simplify the direct tax law to ease the easing the business. They are doing for the reform in the direct taxation law. They have made various reform, but still it's a very confusing means. I believe that direct taxation is the most confusing thing. Confusing law, because for an individual there are different tax slab for different schemes. They are presumptive taxation. They have different rates. So even normal person, it's very difficult to remember. So government is working on this behalf as well.
Can you tell me one good reason for having two types of taxation? What is this? One time they say deductions can be made. On the other hand, they say deductions cannot be made. And why was this introduced? I am not able to understand this. Do you have any idea about that?
I didn't get you. Means what deduction?
No. You know, now we have two ways of taxing us. One is having a base as 2.5 lakhs, then allowing for deduction under Section 80C, deduction for pension, etc., etc. Another one concept is charging income tax only when it is over 5 lakhs without allowing for any of the deductions. So why this type of change has come and for whom it is beneficial, for whom it is not beneficial? I don't understand this.
Okay, sir, got it. There are two taxation schemes basically running for the individual and HUF. One is charging the higher rates and allowing you the deduction, and other is charging a lower rate and without allowing you the deductions. So these two are basically introduced for the individuals which have the lower income and they are not investing in the ATC and other areas which are being prescribed, like insurance premium, ATC, PPF account, Sukanya Samridhi account. They are not investing in these schemes. And they are earning a lower rate. So government wants to provide them the relief. So this scheme is basically beneficial for them who are earning a lower income and are not investing in this deduction. So they will have to pay the lower tax amount. Okay. And other if this scheme is not there, then they have to pay the higher tax rate and they will not get any deduction. So this will benefit to those, but earlier scheme will benefit to those who are investing in the ATC, Sukanya, ATC, LIC premium. They are paying LIC premium, insurance premium, FD, tax saver FDs, mutual funds, and insurance premiums. And they have the education loan, they have the vehicles loan. They are benefiting to those individuals.
In fact, here they were having, housing loan repayment, so many things have been disallowed.
Yes, sir.
Then pension,
yeah. Even
pension standard deduction, if, everything has been disallowed.
Yes, sir. Even last year, there is a deduction, new deduction, ATEEP is recently introduced. Mm-hmm. That will allow you 150,000 deduction on interest payment of an electric vehicle. So government are promoting electric vehicles through these means by providing the taxation rebate.
Oh, interest on electric vehicle loan.
Yeah, sir.
Oh, very fine.
Up to 150,000 under Section 80.
Very good. Thank you. So that is allowed in the new scheme also, or only under the old scheme and the old rate of this thing? Supposing
it is for the old, it is for the old scheme.
Old
because in new scheme you have to means forego all your deductions if in order to avail for a lower benefit.
Very
and I personally believe that this new scheme is not beneficial for many of us because we have the natural tendency to buy the property, to invest in these schemes, and
not
to
only
get
that,
an higher education loan.
You need to have LIC policy for your safety.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Yeah, basically.
You have clarified the doubt nicely. Very good. Okay. So you said you appeared for FCI interview with me. And
yes, sir.
Where was your interview? In that Gurugram, no?
So it, yeah, no. Yeah. There's FCI only takes interview, all the interview in the Gurugram.
You had GD also, or GD was not there?
No, sir. GD was not there.
Not there.
Only PI.
So why, what? Achha, you said you have scored very well in the interview, but only you scored
sir.
Less in the... What were the
main
questions
exam,
asked to you in the interview?
They asked the very simple questions. Basically, if I talk about the technical, then the questions are very simple. They have asked me the golden rule of accounting. They have asked me about the contingent liability. They have asked me why dividends are not paid through revaluation reserve. So I will find questions
very
were
simple.
Very easy.
Very easy.
Yeah, technicals were very simple. Yeah, for me, basically, I'm a chartered accountant. So in these things that we have already studied.
And
it's
was
not
very
a problem
easy
for us.
But
they have asked me means very strange questions as well. They said ki you are very well dressed up. You have trimmed your beard very well, and your senior will not like this. How can a junior will dress like this? Means more than I. So how will you deal? Means your senior will tell ki you are not working properly, but you are dressing up very nicely. So how will you deal with it? So I have told them that if my senior believe that I am not working hard, I am not performing good, then I will definitely work harder. But for dress up, I will means I think my senior will influence from me. They will get dressed up better. So they are laughing. So they
exactly.
ask me this.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You look very presentable. Absolutely. Okay. No problem. That's right. What they told is 100% correct. And
yes,
you scored, you missed by 6 marks. That means it's a very high mark.
Yeah, I missed by, even interview I get 20 out of 20, then still I will not make
still it. You would have missed by 3 marks.
Yeah. Yes, yeah. Still I would make.
Oh,
actually, I have made many mistakes in this NABARD mains examination. I personally feel that.
Not NABARD.
I have made very
said FCI main.
FCI. FCI. But NABARD in NABARD,
main,
I'm.
NABARD, you have done it well.
I have made. Yeah, I think, I believe I.
You have done
have
it
made
well.
Well.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Good. Now, coming to this food, I was asking Food Corporation of India for many people at that time, you know.
Yes,
yeah.
Sir, yes, sir.
Yeah. So many people.
You were very busy.
Yeah, I was very busy. I was in Delhi, in Chennai. That now I'm in Canada. That's the problem.
Yeah, you know? I can see the daylight.
Yeah, daylight.
but here it's all night.
yeah. Correct. Now tell me about NABARD. Government sponsored schemes. What is it they mention in their website? Please tell me something about their government sponsored schemes. Did you go through that? Did you study about that?
Yes, I have studied about the NABARD schemes, which on which the NABARD is working.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I'm asking.
Gone through the government scheme.
Here, government-sponsored schemes given under our NABARD. Apart from this, there are so many other government-sponsored schemes. So that is separate.
Yes, sir.
Is related to banking. Yes, I'm not asking that.
Yes, sir.
I'm asking only related to NABARD.
Okay. Basically, NABARD have set up the RIDF fund, Rural Infrastructure Development Fund, by which NABARD is basically financing for the rural development, means by building the bridges and irrigation facilities for the farmers. Mm. And secondly, NABARD also also for the animal husbandry, they have set up the Animal Husbandry Infrastructure Development Fund, in which they will provide the credit facilities to the farmers for their animals, for purchasing animals and for the maintenance of them, and for the rural development, for the agriculture purpose also, there is a fund called Agriculture Infrastructure Development Fund.
It's okay, but I see something else here. Under this government sponsor scheme, they have given New Agricultural Marketing Infrastructure Sub-Scheme of ISAM, Agri Clinics and Agri Business Centers, National Livestock Mission, Dairy Entrepreneurship Development Scheme, then Commercial Production Units of Organic Inputs, National Project on Organic Farming, GSS, Ensuring End Use of Subsidy Released. I only know the last one, Interest Subvention Scheme. Can you tell me something about Interest Subvention Scheme?
Yeah, in Interest Subvention Scheme, government is basically providing the farmers interest subsidies through NABARD. They are giving 2% or 3% interest subsidies for Rabi and Kharif crops. And there is an amount also I'm missing.
I think you have not studied this.
Cannot recall.
The government of India.
Yes, sir. I have not gone through this
scheme. The government of India has extended the interest subvention scheme on Kisan credit card issued to crop loan farmers to the KCC issued to animal husbandry and fisheries farmers. Interest subvention of 2% to banks and 3% to farmers towards prompt repayment incentive is extended on short-term loans up to rupees 2 lakh to animal husbandry and fisheries farmers apart from existing KCC crop loans, provided the loans are extended by banks at 7% per annum. Out of the 7%, 3% interest subvention is given. And so, 2% subvention to banks, and 3% to farmers. So 7 plus 2 minus 2, 5.
5%.
I think 5% jaane se to out of 7, only 2% hoga. But I normally learned that they are being charged 9%. So 3%, 2%, 4% only the farmers will be paying.
Okay.
So please get to know about this government-sponsored scheme.
Yes, sir.
And only these government-sponsored schemes, what are the government-sponsored schemes which are beneficial for, which you studied under FCI, that soil subsidy scheme, so many things, soil study scheme. So
yeah, there are various
other schemes that like, say, drip irrigation, all those schemes also, you must get to know about them also, okay?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir, sure.
Yeah. Thoda padh lijiye. And who is the chairman of our NABARD now?
Currently, it's G.R. Chintala.
Govinda Rajulu Chintala.
Govinda Rajulu Chintala, yeah.
Good. So what is the main function of NABARD?
So basically, NABARD provide credit facilities to the RRBs, to state credit cooperative societies, to central credit cooperative society, and to farmer producer organization. Also, NABARD assists the government or RBI in the policy formation with respect to related to the rural development. Also, NABARD has the regulating, NABARD is a regulating body, and it regulates the functions of RRB, credit cooperative societies, and also it's monitor their functions as well, and monitor and supervision. And NABARD also work for the rural development by establishing a fund called in RIDF, Rural Infrastructure Development Fund, and it also work for the agriculture development. They have for this, they have also the Agriculture Infrastructure Development Fund. Apart from this, NABARD also help its collaborating agencies in the credit for policy formulation. And it's also supports the government schemes as well, for the, like we discussed, the government center government sponsored schemes, that NABARD helps in the introducing these schemes or implementing these schemes. It also helps in the financial inclusion of, exactly, of rural areas as well.
Exactly.
Yes, sir.
So what do you understand by financial inclusion?
So financial inclusion is basically providing the banking services to the rural areas, to all the sectors of the society. They're opening their bank accounts and making them aware of the different banking subsidies, banking facilities to them. Making them the part of the financial sectors.
Mm-hmm. So, could you have an opportunity to go through the case studies given in the website? Maybe you would not have had time. Here,
No, sir.
Case studies, they are telling pulses of the nation, Uttar Pradesh. So many things they are giving. Thoda usko bhi padh lijiye na.
Yes, sir.
Be thorough with that also. See, initiative pilot project on augmenting productivity of pulse crops. Farmers of Jhansi district. The challenge is pulses are the major sources of protein to vegetarians. Productivity of pulses is very poor. Agronomic practices followed are primitive. High-yielding varieties and proper practices are required to be adopted for enhancing productivity. But breaking the jinx is not easy. Solution. Both kuch diya hai. Padh liji.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You please read that. That will help you. Good. So are you reading newspapers? Are you reading latest newspapers?
I'm not a regular newspaper reader, but I refer the news. I read the news through the through the apps, in Shorts apps and Study IQ channel. I watch daily basis. Mm-hmm. Channels.
So that is how you. But in the interview, don't say like this. In the interview,
Ab
aisa mat boliye. I am not reading news. Bolne se to acha lagta nahi hai. You say you are reading news through other means. Paper mein nahi padta hai, but you are reading news somehow or other.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Today's news dekhta hoon. COVID-19 vaccine for kids above 15.
Yes, sir. Government has started a booster shot.
Booster dose for 60 plus to be given from January.
Yeah, and for the doctors and
medical
staffs.
Yeah. And many people are infected with, what is the name of the new virus?
Omicron, sir. It's a Omicron. It's basically originated from Africa. It's not clear from where it is originated, but most likely Omicron is started from this. And there is one death reported through Omicron, by Omicron in UK.
Only one.
Currently, India has 400 plus cases of Omicron, right? Today,
so I think though death may not be there, I think they are fearing it may affect many people.
Yeah. The spreadness rate of spread is very high. This Omicron version, the spread rate is very high, but it's not that fatal.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Now, what is your father?
My father is a retired person. They used to be own a medical shop, but we have sold it.
my father was having a medical shop which has been sold.
Medical shop.
Correct?
Which has been sold.
How many siblings do you have? How many siblings?
One sibling, sir. I have one elder brother.
Elder brother. What is he doing?
So he's working in TCS.
Oh, good. Achha, you are now working for which chartered accountant company?
So actually, I left the job when I see the notification of NABARD in August. Then only I have left the job and started preparing for
now. You are preparing for jobs only. Good.
Excellent. Yes, sir.
That's right. That is correct. Absolutely no problem. Now, talking about commerce, talking about chartered accountancy.
Sure.
What is debt equity ratio?
So debt equity ratio is debt upon equity, and it shows how much debt a company owns. Company has taken how much percentage of debt, and ideal debt equity ratio is 2:1. But for infrastructure company, it is 6:1. But if a company have a higher ratio, then it is very detrimental to the health of the company, as we have seen in the case of Reliance Power. Where the debt is very high, so the interest burden is also increased for the company, and this ends up in the debt trap. It's like a debt trap where the company is very difficult for the company to recover from it, and it's also not beneficial to have a lower debt, because debt is considered to be as the cheaper cost of capital. So an ideal use of debt is very beneficial for the company.
Correct. Good. Now, what way this ratio analysis is made use of by chartered accountants like?
So ratio analysis is useful in many ways. For the credit worthiness of the company, with how liquid is the company? Means how easily can a company can pay to its current liabilities, that is basically denoted from this ratio analysis, and also the long-term stability of the company, long-term solvency, means a company will not get bankrupt in future. This can also be analyzed by the ratio analysis. Also, banks see the ratio analysis, their trends, that whether the company is liquid and solvent or not. And also for the performance point of view, ratio analysis is very useful. You can compare company with the other companies, whether this company is performing well or not, it's making generating profit for the shareholders or not. So in many ways, a ratio analysis is useful for all creditors, bankers, governments, etc.
Good. You are from Uttar Pradesh.
Yes, sir.
Your elections are going to take place next year?
Yeah, in February or March. Yes.
February or March. That's right. I'm not asking about which party will win and all. That's very bad.
That's not in our hands.
Yeah. Can you tell me something about Lakhimpur incident?
Lakhimpur. Yes, I've read about it. Lakhimpur, in there, son of an MP is has
not MP, minister.
What it can say?
Minister,
yeah, son of a minister. Ramp Fortuner over the farmers rally. It's a very unfortunate incident. And
how many people died?
Around 2 or 3 people, farmers have been died.
थोड़ा उसका बारे में उसका बारे में पढ़ के रख लीजिए, whether you like it or not, you have to know about Varanasi,
yes,
and its development, Ayodhya and its problems. ये तो जरूर आपको जानना जरूरी है. Good.
Yes, sir. Recently, Kashi Vishwanath is also in.
Lot of problems are there. So उसको पढ़ लीजिए better, and especially, but I don't know why this UP farmers were participating in this farmer strike. I don't know. Because only Punjab
UP people, farmers,
yeah, they also participate.
Yeah, most of the But I think it's very negligible, means they're very rare. Mostly they are from Punjab and Haryana, because MSP benefit is most of the farmers in Punjab and Haryana are getting MSP benefit.
Yeah.
So they are mostly Haryana.
They are the most people benefited, so that's correct.
Yes, sir.
Now, how do you update yourself with your chartered accountancy profession duties?
Okay. So I on a regular basis read about the amendments whichever the government introduced in direct taxation, indirect taxation, Companies Act and all, and I also, when the budgets are yet to come, I also analyze, and after the budget I read what are the means steps or what are the amendments government has introduced. And I read newspaper through other media on a daily basis, and by all these I keep on updating myself, and I do practical.
Why did you not mention about your chartered accountancy manual? Usme se bhi knowledge milega.
Okay. Yes, definitely.
And also, it seems chartered accountants are supposed to attend some program once in a year.
Yeah, they are seminar. Yeah, we have to means complete the CPE hours.
Why don't you mention about that?
Yeah.
I think that is there only for practicing
chartered accountancy. It's also for the members, means it's also for the employment.
Supposing you are going to be employed in NABARD, can you attend that?
Yes, sir. But the hours are less. Means practicing chartered accountant have to attend the CP hours of more duration. Mm-hmm. But a employed person have to attend
lesser number of hours. Good.
Yes, lesser number.
Because some other chartered accountant told me. That's why I asked.
Okay.
Good.
Yes, sir.
In fact, many people have got selected in FCI. From our interview,
yes, sir.
A lot of people have got selected. It depends.
Yeah, it's a very good post.
That, it depends on that particular, subject, you know. That is
yes, sir. Yeah,
very good. Now, do you have any questions at this stage? Kuch doubts
regarding.
You are not answered well in about NABARD ka bare mein theek se. बोला yes, नहीं एंड गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स के बारे में और भी पढ़ लीजिए.
यस आई एम वेटिंग फॉर द फाइनल रिजल्ट बेसिकली.
आई नो
या
अदरवाइज
देन आई विल डेफिनेटली
गो. हाउ विल यू मैनेज अ क्वेश्चन ऑन व्हाट आर योर हॉबीज.
सो माय हॉबीज इज प्लेइंग क्रिकेट एंड वाचिंग मूवीज सीरीज एंड आई आल्सो like driving, means go on a long drive.
Which movie did you see last which you liked very much?
Yes, sir. Recently I watched this Bazaar.
Bazaar?
And yes, it's basically related to the stock market.
Acha? Uh-huh. It's a new movie?
I have an interest in the stock market as well. So uh-huh. It's
Achcha, that is why. Do you invest in shares sometimes?
Yes, sir. Yeah, I do invest in shares.
Now, which shares are going up now?
Sir, it depends. Currently, I have invested in Central Bank, in Punjab National Bank, because there are quite attractive returns in there. Means their EPS are quite high. Comparing to it with their current market price, I believe this share will definitely go in the higher.
Abhi in near future. Central Bank share ka price kitna hai?
Currently, it's traded at 21 rupees.
Arre bhai,
but there is a lot of news of privatization.
Usme jada paisa to nahi milega na? Why don't you invest in good shares? Bahut paisa chahiye, lekin, like when you want to invest in Infosys, TCS.
Infosys and TCS is no doubt a very good companies. But if you have to take more risk for more gain, I basically believe I will get higher return in these companies. because Infosys, Reliance, HUL are already means valuing at a premium bit.
Mm-hmm.
People are ready to pay premium prices for these shares.
Mm-hmm.
They are trading at a premium. Means for double for getting these shares, double are very rare chance. But shares like a central bank
central bank?
Other BPCL is also good.
Mm-hmm. What about
BPCL shares?
Did you invest in IOB?
Indian Overseas Bank.
Not much.
So yeah, no, I have not invested in IOB, but I have seen means its financials. It's a very means good. In terms of EPS, earning PE ratio.
What about Bank of Maharashtra?
I believe Bank of Maharashtra is nice, but after privatization, it will definitely go on a higher side.
Mm-hmm. Good, good. That's
it means we have to wait for the privatization. We can hold these shares.
So now, what is the logic behind the share prices going up at a time when the country is suffering out of COVID and a lot of movements are not there? In spite of it, why the share prices are going up? Who is responsible for this?
So, if I talk about who's responsible, then obviously there is DIs and FIs who's responsible in means for a price rise and fall. But market is on higher side. The reason for this, I've seen this only one reason, which investors see on a future side. Means they see for the after 6 months, what is the condition of the economy. So even before coronavirus came to India, the share market have fallen drastically. This is the reason because investor knew that after COVID, the economy will go into lockdown. So currently market is on a higher side because the investor will see a value in the means where they will see that India will definitely perform better after 6 months or after 2 to 4 months. This is the main situation. But there are many various means other factors as well, like interest rates are going on a higher side in America. So FIs are pulling their money out of India. This makes the market in for correction. Means currently there is a correction in the market. For this is the reason. And other government subsidies, schemes, and budget is also a major factor.
Okay, so you feel foreign investment is also a lot of money is coming in. They expect more in India.
Yeah, coming into India.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. That's why they invest in India. But if the interest rates are means go on a higher side, because they also borrow money from the banks and others. So if the interest rate in their country go high, they will start investing in their own country. So they will pull out money from India. This will lead into correction in the market.
That is a reason for fluctuations. Yeah, very good.
Yes, sir.
Any other points you would like to tell at this stage? Kuch doubt arayam?
Which?
No. You have answered.
Doubt means
you have answered general questions and all correctly, but the short stock market and all this and all you are telling correctly. But when I came to NABARD, you were not able to tell correctly.
Only one reason for this.
Thoda padhne ke baad mein aur ek baar milenge, we will talk.
Yes, sir. Definitely, sir. Mm-hmm. Once the main result were
general questions, I think you can easily answer. Most common interview questions, you are aware about that. 50 yes, common interview. Yes, what are strengths, weakness, etc. You can manage.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Your interview is good one.
Manage.
Best wishes.
Yes, sir.
Anything
sir,
else?
Can you rate? Yeah, can you rate?
Rate
means I will definitely work
for today's rating is out of 10, 8.
Okay, sir. I will 10? Definitely means work hard.
Yeah.
Out of I have 10, given 8. 2 interview.
Earlier to me.
Okay, at FCI time. Yeah, earlier. I have given 2 interview to you.
Okay.
And in that, I have improved my performance in the second interview.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe in future, I will
this time also, when you come for second time for NABARD, maybe after the dates are announced, you prepare like a real interview and come so that it will be better. Best wishes.
Definitely, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thanks
a lot.
Bye.
Thanks, sir. Bye, sir.
Bye.